like the city air, I like to drink of it. The more I know New York, the more I think of it. I like the sight and the sound and even the stink of it. I happen to like New York. I like to go to Battery Park and watch those liners booming in. I often ask myself, why should it be? They should come so far from across the sea. I suppose it's because they all agree with me. They happen to like New York. On Sunday afternoon, I took a trip across to Hackensack. But when I gave Hackensack the once over, I took the next train back. I happen to like this bird. I happen to like this town. And when I have to give the world my last farewell and the undertaker starts to ring my funeral bell, I don't want to go to heaven, don't want to go to hell. I happen to like New York. I happen to love New York.
Come on, you promised to sit through the entire hockey game without being bored, and I'll sit through the Wagnapper with you next week. I already bought the earplugs.
Yeah, well, with your eyesight, I'm surprised you can see the puck.
God, I can't wait to get into bed and stretch out. You know, there's a Bob Hope movie on television later.
I know. Do you believe this guy in Indiana killed 12 victims, dismembered them, and ate them?
Really? Yeah, it's an alternative lifestyle.
Yeah, we'll see.
Call the elevator.
We're coming.
Call the elevator.
Sorry.
Thank you,
babe. Okay. Oh, I see you at the gym sometime.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, we live in the apartment down the hall.
Oh, well, I go whenever I have the discipline. Oh,
it's important to put that time in. Does wonders.
Oh, God, yeah, I agree.
Exercising changed my life. Just.
I prefer to atrophy. I'm not a big exercise person.
We bought a treadmill last week.
Oh, well, we had one, but, you know, we got rid of it because it was just taking up too much space.
Because you have to turn it on and get on once in a while. That was our problem.
It's so confusing with all those buttons and computerized programs. I'm just never going to get that.
Now I know.
Yeah, so well.
I know, this is the funny
one to come up and say
anyway,
hello.
Good
night. Oh, say hello.
Huh?
Say,
yeah.
Listen, why don't you come in for a second and have a drink with us?
Oh.
Love that.
Oh, well, that'd be
makes
fun.
Great Irish coffee.
Yeah, please.
This is
a
movie on television. I want to check.
Treadmill.
Oh, well, the Oh, listen, if I can figure it out, then believe me, anybody can.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Oh,
no. Let's look.
Please,
book.
It's easy.
Wonderful book they've given me. Now I'm at level 5. That
what?
I know.
Well, you're that advanced? God,
I
only got to level 2.
I work out all the time. Look at these diagrams. Do you
That's
believe
amazing.
I can't understand this even.
I see.
Yeah. Well, see this.
Now let me show you a mint 1933 airmail. Very rare and very beautiful. Look at that. And this plate block is quite unique because it has a flaw in the engraving. See if you can see it.
It's hard.
Give you a little hint
actually.
Right down here in the corner. See?
Oh, that,
interesting.
That little tiny thing there.
Yeah.
Oh,
that makes it quite valuable, you see.
Uh-huh.
And I just got a commemorative set of issues that are going to be quite valuable, too.
Yes.
Look at the color work there. Well, all these are going to become a real full.
We're probably keeping you up,
oh,
right?
Oh, no, this is wonderful.
I should be going.
What do you do, if I may ask?
Me? I'm in book publishing. I work up at Harper's.
Why, you really?
Yeah.
I own an old cinema, having it redone.
Oh,
used to have a string of three, but, you know, business is not what it used to be. Now, look at these presidentials. Look at the color work. Even the perforations are still in there.
Where's Carol? I should really be going, actually.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Coffee's
little
ready.
Oh.
Coffee. I forgot coffee.
Good. We can get back to this later. Come on in.
Well, we never had any children, but it's easy to emphasize. What college does your son attend?
Brown.
Oh.
Nice color.
Paul never attended college. He's self-made.
Always regretted it. I think knowledge is the second most important thing. First is health, then knowledge.
Hmm.
been money.
You know, it's amazing how time works.
Well, actually, I used to work at an ad agency, but that was many years ago. But, you know, I've been seriously thinking of starting a little restaurant. Well, Larry, he's trying to talk me out of it.
Well, she's a great cook, though, really. Her duck and fennel omelet on a bed of scallops and hollandaise sauce with truffles and sweetbreads will make you snap into a fetal position and lay on your bed screaming for a month.
He loves to tease me, but actually, he really loves exotic food.
Oh, my weakness is any rich dessert, cream, butter, anything with cream.
Oh, well, listen, I'll fix your dessert that'll make your eyeballs roll up. You'll have to exercise a month to work it off.
Yeah. We're going to Le Cirque for our anniversary.
No, really?
28 years, November.
Really?
Well, what do you buy the woman who has everything?
We already have twin cemetery plots.
Well, I always think a Bentley is in good taste, you know what I mean? Or you can go the route that I went with her on her 20th. I got her some very lovely handkerchiefs.
Yeah, oh, no, but, you know, they had my initials on.
Yeah, it was very, very high class. And I didn't even know her size. Jesus, couldn't you keep the conversation going a little longer in there? I mean, I was signaling you frantically.
Well, I was just trying to be neighborly.
Neighborly? If this guy showed me his stamp collection one more time... My favorite thing in life is to, you know, look at canceled postage.
Oh, come on, Larry. It was sweet. They, you know, they're looking forward to their anniversary.
Yeah, and I'm looking forward to seeing that Bob Hope movie. I don't know why they put it on so late.
Do you think that's going to happen to us?
Oh, what?
Well, that we'll become like them, you know, just another dull aging couple, you know, with our little walks.
You're a dull aging
couple. Our TV, our locks and bagels, and our twin cemetery plots.
No, we should be as lucky as them to, you know, to be in their physical shape at their age. They look great. You see the dumbbells this guy lifts?
Yeah.
If I lifted dumbbells like that, I would get a hernia the size of the San Andreas Fault.
Hey, how often do you think they make love?
Oh, you know, probably more than we do in their shape, you know. You know, I'm sure as much as once a week.
Oh, Larry?
God, I'm exhausted. What?
Do you still find me attractive?
Of course. What kind of question is that? Of course I do.
Yeah, but we're not turning into a pair of comfortable old shoes, are we, do you think?
Never comfortable. I don't think you have to worry about that. How you guys doing?
We're fine.
We're
good. We're going to get this one.
That's very nice, actually.
So actually,
are we going to see you at Elaine's Thursday?
Oh, no. Thursday's our Wagner opera.
Uh-huh. You know, Ted's coming to Elaine's with us.
Ted? How is Ted?
He seems to be doing well. I mean,
I think he's glad he's divorced. Come on. He's not doing well at all. He's not used to it.
I think he's glad.
So what do you want to do? You guys are going to browse?
No, we're going to go to a movie.
We're going to go see Double Indemnity.
Right.
Oh, really?
Why don't you come with us?
It starts in a little while.
I'd have the police after her so fast it'd make her head spin. They put her through the ringer. And Bubba, the things they would squeeze out.
Well, we haven't got a single thing to go on, please.
Oh, not too much. Just 26 years experience, all the percentage there is, and this hunk of concrete in my stomach.
God, that movie was great, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's one of my favorites. It was also wonderful in the picture.
Who can we fix Ted up with? I mean, there must be somebody in your office. Yeah.
I don't know. Ted, I always thought Ted had a crush on you.
Me?
Yeah, I'm so stunned.
Please. I mean, I adore him, but, you know, he's like a girlfriend to me.
And now he's divorced, you know.
Do I detect a note of jealousy?
I had to come up here and call 911.
Is that the EMS?
I'm a doctor in the EMS.
What's going on? What happened?
She had a heart attack.
Oh my God.
She's dead.
She's dead?
They're giving Mr. House a sedative right now. He's running around like crazy.
She really was.
I called EMS. They got here as soon as they could, but it was too late.
We just met.
It was just awful.
What happened?
Well, it's a classic car narrative. It just went like that.
Oh, is there anything we can do?
We need to be good neighbors. Yes. You know, we've calmed him down.
The first time we saw them was last night. We just met them. We had them.
This is such a nice lady.
Nice, sweet person.
God, okay.
Wonderful.
Oh, hello. Hi, Mr. Haston.
Thank you. Wonderful flower.
Oh.
That's quite nice of you.
Anything we can do, anything you need, God. It's just such a shock, wasn't it? I mean, it was just so sudden. I mean, she seemed so, God, well, healthy.
She had a heart condition.
She did?
Mm.
She never mentioned it.
She wouldn't have.
No. Right. Well.
If there's anything we can do.
Yeah, anything, really.
If you're lonely, come by, you know, whatever you like.
No, you owe me a wonderful French dessert.
Oh, no, no, no. I know. I haven't forgotten. Believe me.
Well, have a nice time. You saw the old Gussie there?
Oh, I know. We're going to the opera.
Oh, enjoy.
Yeah.
Good night.
Thanks.
Good night.
Come, we're
going to
be late.
I sit through the ice hockey game and you watch the whole opera.
I can't listen to that much Wagner, you know? I start to get the urge to conquer Poland.
Taysa, I think it's weird. I mean, listen to this. One night she's having coffee, and the next night they're carrying her out in a rubber bag.
Oh, I know. And she did not look like she was ready to go.
Really?
No, she looked. Maybe this guy killed her, you know? Like he's got like a young Tootsie stash.
No, not this one. You gotta see this guy. This guy gets his jollies from licking the back of postage stamps. He's a boring.
Well, I could see that, depending on whose picture is on the stamp.
She never once mentioned that she had a heart condition.
Well, what is she going to say? Hello, I'm Mrs. House, and I'm a bad heart.
Well, she had no problem telling me about her hysterectomy in the first 5 minutes.
It's much easier to talk about a hysterectomy than just to talk about
her heart. She liked to eat high cholesterol desserts. Is that what you said?
So she had one too many.
No, no, she wasn't on a diet. We discussed diets.
She wasn't on a diet.
This would be a really great way to kill somebody.
How?
You clog their arteries with whipped cream, chocolate mousse, butter. They go like that.
That's great.
Yeah, disgusting, but it's
I love it.
Wouldn't that be great?
I'd like to French pastry myself to death right now.
I'll help you.
I really would. All right. In fact, I'd like another piece of pie right after
finish.
This. Do I dare?
Are you going to start a restaurant? Are you serious about that?
Really, you should. You're a great
cook. If you do, count me in. I want to be part of that. Really?
Really?
You should. No. Well, I don't know. I mean, are you serious?
Yeah. Oh, God, it'd be wonderful.
What are you encouraging her for? It's
she's a great cook.
She is.
Well, thanks to you, actually. I mean, it was his idea of the cooking lesson. So, I mean.
Yeah, but a restaurant is serious business. I mean, you just can't take that lightly. You can't be cavalier about a restaurant.
I'm not being cavalier about it.
Well, you say, I mean, just like that, you're going to... Yeah, you
should be there every night. You should be stuck there, you
know. Wait, look.
They steal from you.
But it's great.
You've got to be
there. It's what I do. It's what I do, Larry.
She's great. She's a pro. She's a pro. She'll be cooking. She'll be cooking in the kitchen. I'll be at the front running the joint like Rick, you know, and Casablanca.
You can do it anyway. Might as well get paid.
I'm serious about it. I mean, it's not like a hobby. I think that'd be a serious
thing. I'll be the first customer.
You know, I was thinking of fixing Ted up with Helen Dubin. But then I figured they would just, you know, get into an argument over penis envy or something. Poor guy suffers from it, so.
Didn't he seem a little too cheerful?
Yeah, he seemed like his regular self to me. But when you brought up the notion of the restaurant, the guy lit up like Mr. Glowworm.
The restaurant?
Yeah, he sees himself as, you know, as Humphrey Bogart in Casablanca. I see him more as Peter Lorre.
No. I mean, Mr. House. Mr. House, didn't he seem a little too cheerful to you?
Mr. House, our next-door widower?
Yes. I mean, he seemed too composed for a man whose wife just died, don't you think?
Well, Jesus, what do you want the guy to do, walk down the street sobbing hysterically?
Well, I don't know. All I know is they were supposedly looking forward to their, you know, anniversary, and you know, if I suddenly dropped dead, wouldn't you sob for months or years
Don't make those kind of jokes, okay? I don't like those remarks. And meanwhile, I'm the guy who needs a physical checkup.
Well, I don't know. I mean, to me, he just seemed a little too perky, you know? Now suddenly he wants his French desserts and have a nice time, you know, at the opera, and my God, we're certainly dressed up. I mean, you know, this guy should be a wreck.
Meanwhile, I can't get the Flying Dutchman theme out of my mind, you know? Remind me tomorrow to buy up all the Wagner records I can. Rent a chainsaw.
Helen Dubin's wrong for Ted.
Yeah.
She's too mousy.
Oh, he's a little mousy, too. They can have their little rodent time. They can eat cheese together. Oh, Christ. Hello? Yes, of course you woke us. You know, not everybody is up at 1 o'clock in the morning watching the porn channel. I'll put her on.
Who is it?
Ted.
Oh.
For you.
Oh. Ted, huh?
I figured out how he killed her, made it look like a coronary. He gagged her and tied her to the treadmill, and then he turned the exercise program up to Olympic levels.
No, I know.
You know, I mean, I just think this guy is too perky, you know? I mean, he's not acting like a man whose beloved of 28 years died just a few days ago.
Jesus, what to that? God.
Yeah.
Just joking.
I know.
Let me speak to him.
What?
Oh,
here, just say, here's my...
Hey, listen. She was not murdered. She had a heart attack. It was a colonel. There was a doctor there. He said to her, he's an old man.
How do you know he's a real doctor?
I'm not going to touch that. I'm tired. I want to go to sleep.
Wait a minute. Put Carol back on. I called about something else. Listen, I know a great location for a restaurant.
Well, it's these walls dark.
It's like a cave. You like you have to go through a little cave. Then you come out.
Oh, look at this, though. Huh? It's really so beautiful. But it's kind of out of the way for a restaurant, isn't it?
No, that's the appeal. That's just the appeal.
Uh-huh.
Because it's so romantic tucked away back in here like this.
Yeah.
You don't want street trade. You want a little out of the way spot that people hear about and lovers go to. Takes months to get a reservation, you know, very
really
few tables.
Out,
oh, well, I used to come here all the time with Julie when
uh-huh.
we were married.
Right.
Used to walk around here. It's really beautiful at night. It's gorgeous at night.
It's beautiful.
I used to think, what am I doing here with Julie? We don't love each other anymore. Made the moment doubly poignant.
Hi. How are you? These are my floating islands. I hope you like meringue.
I'd love it. Come on in. Come on in.
Well,
this is unbelievable.
I know.
Did you do it?
I did do it. Yeah. I told you. Anyway, this is vanilla sauce here, and I put chocolate truffles.
What'd you share it with me?
No, it's too much for one.
I'll make some coffee.
I'll make the coffee. That'd be better. Let me make it.
You've done so much.
No, I insist. Go on. Sit down. Relax. Enjoy yourself.
Nice.
You've been through enough.
Did you work on those How you holding up?
Oh, I don't know. I was thinking after a while I'd get away from here, from this place and all its memories.
So you have someone to go with?
I have a brother in Florida, hoping he could get away for a while.
Good. It's a good idea.
Do you like snorkeling?
Snorkeling? No. I get nervous when brightly colored fish are staring at me face to face, you know.
Hey, I've got some stamps I wanted to show you.
Oh, stamps. Wow.
Well, look at these. These This is really delicious.
Thanks.
You are an artist.
Well, thanks very much. Was it a large funeral?
Oh, no. We had very few friends, no family.
Just a simple affair, huh? Mm-hmm. Well, they're the best, aren't they?
Yeah.
I guess, anyway. Then you're laid to rest and... You know, I was just... Where are the twin cemetery plots? Because we were thinking that was just such a romantic idea, weren't we, Larry? You know, Larry? You remember when we were talking about the twin cemetery plots and, you know, how kind of romantic that is? Remember? Mm-hmm.
Yes, we were. We were spending eternity with the beloved. I sound like one of those guys now.
Yes.
No, but I was just wondering, where is the cemetery?
Oh, it's in Nyack. We use the summer there occasionally.
All that stuff about twin cemetery plots, you know? We never discussed it at all, but I knew that you were trying to tell me something, so I picked up on it quickly.
Okay,
I
was in the kitchen, okay, and I was making the coffee. Mm-hmm. There were no beans. So I was looking in his cupboards just to see, and I came across this urn, okay? And I opened it, and there were ashes in it.
Ashes? Funeral ashes? Did you wash your hands?
Larry, he had her cremated.
How did you know it was her? For Christ's sake, they're ashes. What, they resemble Mrs. House?
Who else would it be?
Anybody.
Okay.
Could it be an associate, another relative, and his accountant is capped? Who knows?
Right. Hidden, huh? Hidden away.
What do you mean? The guy didn't do anything.
Look, Larry, all I know is he lied, okay? He lied.
Look, maybe he's embarrassed. Maybe he didn't want to spend eternity next to the beloved. So he told us that, or, you know, what's the difference?
Who are you calling?
Ted!
Oh, Jesus. Leave the guy alone. You know, he's a poor widower. He wants to go on a vacation or something.
Yeah, where? Oh, I know where. Snorkeling, right?
So what? Different strokes. You know, he has fun sitting at the bottom of the water face to face with squid.
Oh, I know. I know. What about this? What if they had a big insurance policy or something like that?
Too much double indemnity, you know?
Hi. Yeah. Hi, it's me. Listen, we were just in our neighbor's apartment, right? Yeah. And get this, I came across an urn with ashes in it. Only, he says he had his wife buried.
That's what you do if you don't want an autopsy. If you don't want something discovered, you know, like poison.
Mmm, right. They'd have detected poison, wouldn't they?
Oh, I don't know. There are a lot of different kinds of exotic poisons, you know?
Yeah, but why would he be lying? I mean, why would he lie
poisons
at all?
They're up to poisons already. Yeah. You guys are slipping into a mad obsession.
Oh, would you do that? That'd be great, because, you know, I'm not good at that kind of thing, okay? All right. Okay, well, I'll talk to you later. Okay, bye.
Let's go to bed. Can we go to bed now?
Hey, I'm not tired.
What do you mean you're not tired?
You know, Ted's going to check with the funeral home tomorrow.
Great.
You know what I mean? I mean, I don't understand why you're not more fascinated with this. I mean, we could be living next door to a murderer, Larry.
Well, New York is a melting pot. I'm used to it. Are you okay?
Larry, I heard a noise. I heard a noise in the hallway, so I looked, and I think Mr. House was getting on the elevator.
Yeah, you sure?
No, I'm almost certain that it was him.
So what? It's not a crime. You can get on the elevator.
I know, but who would be at 1:30 in the morning?
Oh, Jesus, I was in a deep sleep. What's the difference?
But, see, I mean, you know how we're always complaining about living on the geriatric floor? Do you know
what I'm
saying?
All right, so it was Mr. House, so we got on the elevator. It's not a felony. The guy pays rent. He's entitled. Can you go back to bed? This is crazy. You woke me out of a deep sleep. I got to get up early tomorrow morning.
I'm going to ring him up. I'm going to ring his apartment. I'm going to see if he's home.
You're going to ring Mr. House
now?
Yes,
this is really...
Don't ring Mr. House.
What are you doing?
Don't ring Mr. House. This is a widow. Leave the poor guy alone. You're crazy. Stop it.
Don't.
So you saw him go out. It's not a crime.
He's not there yet.
Give me this. Look, if you want to find out if somebody went out, just call downstairs. Call the person at the door.
All right, I'll call.
Ask if somebody went out. Yeah, I'm going to keep ringing. You got it. This is insane. What's gotten into you?
What is he doing? Where is this guy at 1:30 in the morning? You know
what's
what
it's not your business. He can go any place he wants.
Hello? Yes, hello. This is Mrs. Lipton. Yes. Did anybody just leave the building? I was just... You sure? You sure no one... No. Okay. All right. Yes. Thank you.
Okay, are you happy? Now, can we go back to bed? For crying out loud, there's no big deal. You're making a mystery where nothing exists.
Okay, I got it. Wait, I know it. No, wait, listen to me, Larry. Listen. He got on the elevator, okay?
You know, I'm going
to... No, listen to this.
I want to go to sleep. I don't want to be standing here in the middle of the night.
He got on the elevator, and he took it to the basement.
Oh, great. Great. So what? Now what do you got?
He has a car, right? He's got the garage door key.
So what? So what?
What do you mean, so what?
So the next door neighbor went out in the middle of the night, took his car, so he went someplace.
Great. I'm right, though. I mean... I'm right.
So you're right. So big deal. But this kind of right is going to put us in the toilet. So you're right. You're suspicious.
Right.
It says more about your mind
than
about
your
him.
Rigidity? How about
get
that?
Into bed. Get into
that
bed.
Point?
You're so... What's wrong with what? You? Jesus.
Hi.
Jack, do you think you could come upstairs today? Because I got a leak in the kitchen.
Yeah.
You can?
Sure.
Well, but it will be this afternoon, right? You're not gonna,
I'll be
now?
Back in about a minute.
In a minute.
Okay, just wait a second. I'll be right back.
Yeah, okay. All right.
Hello.
Ted. I'm in his apartment. The urn is missing. It's gone. Yeah, I think it might have been... He had the satchel last night. He was carrying this bag, and I think that might have been what he had in his satchel.
Listen, I'd get out of there right away if I were you. No. Go. We'll talk more from your apartment.
He's not going snorkeling with his brother. He's got two tickets to Paris. He's got reservations at the George Sank Hotel with a woman named Helen Moss.
Oh, hi, how are you?
Good morning, how are you?
Good. You got the notice on the maintenance increase?
No, when did that happen?
I'm gonna look around and see what else I can dig up here, okay? Yeah, I'm telling you, this is just dead. I'm just dizzy with freedom. This is the craziest thing I've ever done.
Yes, it's crazy. But soon we'll be too old to do anything crazy. Go, leave.
Hello? Oh, hi. Yeah. I know. Yes, I miss you too. I made all the arrangements. Yeah, look, okay, I have to run. But I'll see you later, okay? Okay. Extension 5. Well, keep ringing, would you please? Because I just talked to her. What? Okay. Would you tell her that... yes, tell her that Tom called? Tom. Thank you.
So I thought your rewrites were great. I really think you helped your book, you know? It's dense a little bit.
No, I don't want it to be too transparent. I mean,
that's something you're never gonna have to worry about, you know? This book makes Finnegan's Wake look like airplane reading, you know? But it's long.
You know, you're the only editor in the world I'll take suggestions from, but even you shouldn't push it.
No, I'm not pushing. I think the book is great, absolutely great, you know? But for how much of Dorothy is you? As I was reading it, I kept thinking, how much did you base it on your own life?
Well, I was a waitress.
Mm-hmm.
I lived with a poet. I was a film critic.
Right, but not a blackjack dealer, right?
No, but I put myself through school playing poker.
Oh, really? Do you still play?
No, but I still know how.
Yes? Are you good?
Yeah.
Yeah, because maybe you could give me some pointers.
I could turn your game around in 2 hours.
Could you? That's great. That's, you know, you have all these skills, and you're beautiful. And you can write so well, and now it turns out you play poker. This is too good to be true.
Well, I wouldn't say beautiful.
Oh, I would.
But I do have tremendous sex appeal.
Okay. You sold me. Are you seeing anybody?
No, don't let my confidence fool you. It's a facade. Why do you ask?
Because I have a friend who became single recently, and I know he would get a big kick out of you.
Wow. So when do you want your poker lessons?
Next week. I could take you to lunch. I'll put you on my expense account, and you could teach me when to bet and when to fold.
How about a cheeseburger right now?
Now? That's a possibility, you know, if we could do this. Hello? Yes? Where are you? Is everything okay? Really? No, I could, sure. I could. Yeah, I need, you know, 5 minutes or so. Okay. Yes, I know where it is. Okay, hold on. I can't do it. I have a little thing that I have to do. I'll do the cheeseburger with you next week or something.
Story of my life.
What do you mean you snuck into his apartment? Are you nuts?
No, stop being such a funny dud.
A funny dud? What are you talking about? That's a crime. You can't do that. That's burglary and breaking and entering. What has gotten into you lately? For crying out loud, save a little craziness for menopause.
It was a cinch. I took the key and I just let myself in.
Look, I don't want to... You wind up rooming with John Gotti. You can't do that. You can't just steal the key and go into somebody's apartment.
Listen, he's not going snorkeling with his brother, okay?
I don't want to know.
Okay,
I don't want to be an accessory.
He's going to Paris to a fancy hotel with a woman named Helen Moss.
Tell Ted. I don't want to know.
I told Ted.
You told Ted before you told me?
Yeah, because he's more open-minded about these things.
Yes, I know. I'm a bore. Because I don't break the law. You know, I live within the Constitution, so
listen,
I'm dull.
Plus, he got rid of the urn, okay?
I don't want to hear.
He talked on the phone with a woman.
How do you know?
Because he came back while I was there, you know, so...
He did?
Yeah, but I hid under the bed.
You hid under his bed?
He didn't see me, Larry. He didn't see me at all.
I cannot believe it. My stomach is curdling here.
He was very lovey-dovey with this kind of bimbo, you know? He kept saying stuff like, you know, don't worry, it's gonna be all right, we're gonna be together, that kind of
but
thing.
But what would you have done if he found you?
I couldn't think that far ahead.
That far ahead? You're
no,
talking
I
two seconds. He could have looked under the bed. And
yeah, but Larry, listen. And then, listen to this. He calls this woman back, probably this Helen Moss woman,
I don't
right?
know. Leave me alone.
And when he calls her back, she's not there. And then he leaves this message, and he says, tell her Tom called. You know what I'm saying? Tom! Tom, yeah, Larry.
Yeah, I know, I get it. His name is Paul, but well, I don't care. Okay. I don't want to hear.
Well, I'll tell you, I thought I did a great job, and so did Ted. I don't think a private eye could have done any better than me. I put everything back where I found it. I was very careful. I made one mistake.
What?
I left my reading glasses on his table. Oh, hello. Hi. I thought I'd bring you some chocolate mousse. I know how much you enjoyed the last dessert, and I thought I'd give you, you know, another shot at something really delicious. Do you want me to serve that for you? Because, you know, you should have it while it's still fresh.
You can divide it up, and we can all have some.
That'd be great. That's a great idea.
I'll get some plates.
Okay, that'd be really good.
That's great.
How are you doing in there? You need any help?
Oh, fine. I'll be right in.
Okay, great.
Are you okay? Can we do anything for you?
Coffee or tea?
Tea. It's what I'd like to have some tea.
You know, I found your glasses.
Mine?
These are yours, aren't they?
Yes.
No. These ones are.
They're actually. They are mine. Honey, they're mine. You know what happened? I think the other night I must have left them here.
Did you?
It's the strangest thing. No. Yeah, I know. Because remember, you were saying that you thought that I left them at your mother's house. That's right. Of course.
That mousse looks
anyway,
fabulous.
It's so good. I love mousse. Hey, listen. Are you looking forward to going snorkeling in the Caribbean?
Uh-huh. It's funny. I found those glasses under my bed.
That's because I must have dropped them, and they probably got kicked under.
You kicked under, right? Because what you do, she'll always drop things, and she'll kick them all around the house.
The moose?
Anyway,
she's always
kicked. I'd love to have some moose.
There was a time you kicked moose under the bed in the house. Remember that?
I remember. It
took 6 months to get the...
Hi, I'm sorry I'm late. The traffic's murder.
No, but where are we going?
I looked up Helen Moss in the phone book. It was just H. Moss.
Right.
So, right. So, Bank Street. We're going to go down and do surveillance. I got a whole lot of food.
There's our house.
All right. So, we should just sit here and wait, huh?
Yeah.
Maybe what? He thought that if he divorced her, she'd hit him for a ton of alimony. Or maybe she controls the family fortune.
Yeah,
what do you think
maybe
of that?
We're wrong, Ted. Maybe we're just, you know, I mean, maybe she died of natural causes like the doctor said, and we're just two people with, you know, hyperactive imaginations whose lives need a little shot of adrenaline.
Is yours? I'll tell you, mine needs something.
Yeah. What's that there?
You want the jelly donut? You want a jelly donut?
Ew.
Huh? Come on. You gotta get into it.
Okay.
Oh my God. Look.
What?
Look.
What?
Helen! Helen! Duck! Duck! Duck!
Oh, God, duck. No.
Helen! It's not her.
It's not her.
No, it's not her. Come on.
Oh, God. You really have this worked out, don't you?
I figured she'd come out and go to work. You know?
Maybe she doesn't work. Maybe she's like you and she has writer's hours.
I'm writing a play about something that happened to you and me.
Oh, God. Oh, dear. What?
Remember that time you and I and Larry and Julie were on that eating tour of France?
Oh, God, yeah.
And they wandered off and they forgot to pick us up. And we had to share that bed and breakfast place.
Right. Do you remember those wonderful cottages? I remember that we shared a bedroom together,
yeah,
right?
Not a bed.
No, not a... Well, God, you were too gentlemanly to suggest that.
Well, it's not that I didn't think of it.
No. Oh, I know what was going on in your mind because of the way you kept plying me with Chateau Margaux, remember?
Could have been our little secret. And you passed out.
Yeah, God. Seems like a long time ago, doesn't it?
Not that long ago.
Mm-hmm.
Go.
Yeah, right.
Shouldn't see.
No.
That's gotta be her. That's gotta be her. I bet it's she answers to hell.
She answers to hell. She's pretty. Mm. She's. What's she doing? She's getting
a camera.
Okay.
Keep that. Don't
worry. Okay, don't worry.
I'm gonna follow her.
Revivals now. This week we have Fred Astaire.
Mm-hmm.
Next week we have an Orson Welles Festival.
Oh, yeah.
I think that'll be about the last thing we do before we start renovating.
Oh, Paul.
Oh, come on. There's nobody around. Come on.
Okay. I've never been behind a movie screen before. Like
strange,
this.
Isn't it?
Yeah.
It used to be a first run house when the neighborhood was better. Oh. Beautiful, huh? Look around.
All these mirrors.
Well, it used to be all mirrors. It was quite beautiful. I'm having all this broken glass replaced as we go along with this renovation. You know, they used to have stage shows here. Yeah. Now, of course, we only show old movies.
It has such a lonely feeling.
That's because I'm the only one here, and my assistant, Mrs. Dalton. Then I'm going to have this place fixed up, then I'm going to sell it. The money's going to come in handy.
Sure will.
What's that noise?
Well,
Mrs. Dalton, I didn't know you were here so early.
Oh, I didn't know whether anyone was here. I'm sorry. I heard a noise and I thought.
It's quite.
But, quite. I apologize.
All right.
I'd love to really get an acting job. I've had it with this modeling.
Maybe you won't have to work at all.
Larry,
come with me, okay?
Oh, jeez, I was...
Come on.
I was fast asleep. I was dreaming of round cod girls.
Okay. Oh, it looks like he's gone. Yeah.
Oh,
he's
Christ,
gone.
Not that again.
Listen, Larry.
Please.
I want to take another look around his apartment. Yeah.
What are you talking about? Where are you going?
Listen.
It's 1 o'clock.
He'll never be back, Larry.
What?
No, he's not coming back. Not for at least an hour.
What'd you do? You got his key?
Yeah.
You're kidding. What are you talking about? You can't do why? Because you followed him to the movie house? You said there was nothing happening.
No, wait a minute. No, he was with this young model type, and they were talking about money.
Well, so what? That's
the motive.
What? Hey, listen to me. Come here.
What are you talking
about?
Come
here. Wait a minute.
Come here.
Look,
what do you mean,
I've been
Larry?
Thinking about you.
What
I
you
think
mean?
You got to see you. I gotta, you, got, you got to go back to your shrink. I want you to see Dr. Ballard again.
Larry, I went for 2 years.
Yeah, I know,
just
but
come,
you know how
come
General Motors will recall defective cars? You got to go in for a tune-up.
We'll be in and out
got,
5 minutes.
No,
honey.
No.
Five,
I,
only...
look, I'm telling you, I'm your husband. I command you to sleep.
Well, all
sleep.
I can... no,
I command it. I command it.
Larry, all I can tell you is if this had been a few years ago, you would have been doing the same thing. Because if you recall, we solved the mystery. Yep, we solved the mystery once. Remember? It was the noises in the attic mystery.
The country house, the bluebird.
That's right.
But that was a sweet mystery. This is murder.
You agree, right?
No,
it's murder,
Larry. Look, no, I forbid you. I forbid you to go. I'm forbidding. Is that what you do when I forbid you? If that's what you, I'm not going to be forbidding you a lot if you do. Don't do this. We should be asleep now in one of our many cuddling positions.
Please be quiet, Larry. Be quiet. You're going to wake up the neighbors, okay? Okay, I got it.
This is no good. I promise you.
Just
this can only lead to great unhappiness.
Relax, okay?
I can't relax. I'm in a strange man's apartment in my t-shirt and pajamas.
All right, now Ted told me to try
what
something.
What do you mean Ted
here?
Told you? Who? Ted, what is he, your mentor? Ted is a sick schmuck. He's home and we're in.
Just be quiet for a second.
What if he comes back?
Shh.
My heart is...
Larry.
Waldron?
Who?
Who is this? Who do you want?
Who's this? Do you have anybody named Waldron?
Walter,
go ahead. Okay. Oh, great. Now they hung up on us.
Good.
Well, great. Now, just let me think for a second now. Waldron, right? Helen Moss? Okay, he used the name Tom, right? So Tom Waldron, we got to run a check on that, okay?
Run a check on it? What, do you want to beat it down to the morgue? You got all the jargon. Where are you going? I'm not a night person. I don't want to be... I don't know what I'm looking for.
Oh, wait. Look.
What? What do you want to do? Go through the guy's mail? This is insane.
What do you mean?
Oh, Jesus. Oh, Christ.
Well, clean it up. Hurry up.
What do you mean clean it up? What am I going to do? Vacuum?
Put it under the rug or something like that.
I can't.
Okay?
It's a wall-to-wall carpet. I broke his porcelain.
Well, then glue it back to...
What do you mean glue it? What are you talking about?
Look.
What?
Look.
So what? Gloves. I have gloves. They keep my fingers warm.
I know, but you keep yours out in the bureau in this kind of weather? Huh?
Let's get out of here, because...
Something's very strange here. I mean, he left these out and ready. I think the whole thing is really sinister.
It's eye of the beholder. What you have to go to the eye doctor to get happy glasses.
I'm
going to take the pieces with us, and we'll get rid of them.
So how did you like your birthday cake?
I loved it.
I know.
I love chocolate.
I know.
If only he could stay in town. If only he could stay in town just a couple of
hours. I was going to, but
what about
they're working us so hard at school, I can't. I got to get it right back.
Really?
I'm going to take him to Brooks Brothers for his present. Your mother's going
to
a wine tasting.
Yeah. Brooks Brothers?
She's going to a wine tasting.
Well, if I'm going to be a restaurant owner, I should know something about wines, don't you? Larry?
Hey, I want you to meet somebody. I want you to meet somebody.
How are you doing?
This is my wife.
Hi, I'm here. I'm right.
Carol,
remember me?
Yeah.
Anyway.
This is Marsha Fox, my son Nicky.
Hi,
he's in town.
See you.
It's his birthday, so we took him
Nick,
to 21. It's a
tradition
we have in the family.
Yeah, that's great. Oh, your friend called me. He's taking me to dinner in New Jersey next week.
I fixed her up with Ted. He's going to tell
you. Oh, you did?
Yeah, we're going to play some
video. Well, very nice.
He's just a lot of fun. You'll have a very good time.
Great.
It's great.
Well, so, good to see you. Good to see you.
Take care.
Thanks for
Goodbye, Marcia.
Oh, it's great. She'll have a great time.
So that's Marcia Fox, huh?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm.
So what are you making a face for?
Wait,
she's
you
great.
Think she's Ted's type? Is that...
Ted's type? She's anybody's type. She's brilliant. She's talented. Yeah, you can catch her back. Yeah.
You know, your pupils are dilating.
Oh, she's dangerously sexual. Let me tell you. Listen, when you go to the wine tasting, honey, getting back to real life, spit it out. Okay.
Don't drink too much, Mom.
Yeah. They spit it out at the wine tasting. You know what I mean? Because I don't want you to be laying on the bathroom floor with your head by the bowl tonight. You know, do all the stuff.
That Mutone 45.
You love it?
Oh, that was like sublime.
Yeah.
You know. And the inexpensive Spanish one. Wasn't that a nice
it's
surprise?
Very,
wasn't
very
that great.
Yeah.
Look at these paintings. Look at this.
So. So Larry fixed you up with Marcia Fox, huh?
Well, you know, writer. He says she's wonderful, and I'm trying to do everything I can to get out and meet people.
Sure.
Well, I'm not looking forward to this.
So you taking her to Vincent's out in Jersey?
I guess. She's not my first choice.
No? God, look at this. Oh,
yeah,
that park is so beautiful.
Of course, I can't have my first choice.
No?
I'm getting drunk. I don't know what I'm saying.
Yeah. So am I. I don't know about this turkey.
I'm going to be late for my shrink.
Gotta go, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. What?
You know, you would be my first choice.
Me? Well...
Well, can I give you a lift? I'm going to go east.
I think I'll stick around. I need to think. I feel a little, tipsy.
I didn't offend you.
No. You didn't offend me. I was very flattered by this. Flattered. Well, anyway. See you. Oops, careful.
Sorry,
whoops.
I got a great sweater at Brooks Brothers for Nick today. Really beautiful. It's cashmere, very expensive. The kid looks so handsome in it, though. Also, I decided I'd cook dinner tonight. My one dish tuna casserole.
Well, no wonder he had her cremated.
What?
Mrs. House.
Oh, Jesus, you're not on about Mrs. House again. I thought we'd have a light dinner, you know, because we had a rich lunch at 21, I thought.
Larry.
What?
I just saw Mrs. House.
What are you talking about, the ashes?
No, a bus. It passed me and she was on it.
The dead woman passed on the bus? Really? Which bus was this? The bus to heaven?
No, but I'm not joking. I mean, I'm telling you something. I'm telling you, I really saw her. I actually saw her.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
You want to lie down for a while? We'll put a cold compress on your head or a hot compress on your back.
Larry, you know, I was at the wine tasting, right? And I was sitting at, you know, a bay window. I happened to look out at bus, and
remember I said to you, spit it out. I said, don't drink it. You said you're going to wine tasting. You said you're going to taste wine all afternoon. I said, spit it out. I said, don't swallow it. You swallowed it, and that's why you're this
way. Okay. I had a few drinks, but it's not, I mean, I saw her.
Yeah, I'm sure you saw her. How could you see her? She's dead. Not only is she dead, she's been cremated. It's not even Halloween.
Are you telling me that I didn't see her? Is that what you're saying?
I think it's a pretty fair assumption that if a person is dead, they don't suddenly turn up in the New York City transit system.
I just don't know what's happening, Larry. I don't know what's going on.
What's going on?
Yeah.
Let me put it this way. Total psychotic breakdown, okay? Is that enough? Maybe she's a twin. That's possible. Now, forget this.
What?
Taste my tuna casserole. Tell me if I put in too much hot fudge.
I mean, you're getting so close-minded these days. I just... God. Hello? Ted.
Ted,
you're not going to believe this, but... Ted, I saw Mrs. House. Yeah, Mrs. House, yeah. The murdered woman, that's
she
right.
She wasn't murdered. It was a coronary. It was a coronary, folks. It was a coronary. She wasn't murdered. I don't know what she's talking about.
No, I'm sure. I'm sure I saw her. Wine. She was on a bus, you know? I mean, I saw it just moments after you left. I was looking out the...
Right.
I'm
he was
sure.
at the wine tasting, too. Sure, why not?
Would you?
I both at the wine tasting.
Would you really... Oh, that would be so great if you just run a check on Paul
don't
and Lillian
check.
House.
Don't
what
run
talking?
A check.
What are you doing?
Listen, I mean, can you call back later? Because my marriage is falling apart.
Larry, what are you...
Forget it. If you're going to have an affair with a guy, you don't need a murder to do it.
I'm telling you, I saw Mrs. House.
Yes, I know, on the bus, the dead person's bus.
Okay.
No car fare. Now sit down.
Now I can tell you, I can show you the exact spot, Larry.
Yeah,
huh?
I'm not
going to
see the exact spot.
Tomorrow?
No, I've got a business lunch tomorrow.
On your lunch hour?
No, I got a business lunch. I'm not interested.
This is just such a shock.
Not interested.
I mean,
come on,
will
you?
I'm just vibrating from this. I mean, I saw this woman. What? Well, I'm not going to the theater.
What do you mean you're not going? We've been holding on to these tickets for 2 months now.
Do you comprehend the enormity of what I'm telling you, Larry?
If you got a big story, tell it to the police. Don't tell it to
me. What am I going to say to him?
Tell him your story. Tell him his whole cockamamie
story. I don't have a story. I mean, I got nothing.
That's right, you got nothing.
Unless I locate her.
Yeah,
huh?
Okay, good.
Okay?
Now, you sit down, because we're going to the theater. I don't care what you say. Oh, Jack. You were there when Mrs. House died, right? You saw her?
Yeah, sure. You saw her lying there, right?
Yes, she was lying on the floor.
But you're sure it was her, right? Yeah, he said he was lying on the floor.
She was in a bed.
Okay,
my wife's been having some bad dreams, and she doesn't know what she's talking about.
Yeah.
This is for all the times I call you to fix the faucet, and you show up 6 months late.
Super is a drunk.
I know, but we've seen him smelling of Jack Daniels, remember?
Yeah, but...
I mean, I know he didn't see Mrs. House, Larry.
If she's a twin, it's a different story, but you don't seem to feel she is.
I don't know. Oh, I know. Unless he's in on it.
He's in on it, the soup?
Yes.
The soup can't change a fuse.
What did she say? Shh. Well, she's alive, and my question is, who was in that bag?
She's not alive unless she's a twin.
Okay, now keep quiet. Look, somebody got cremated, Larry. Somebody.
Shut up.
Lillian House.
Right.
Maiden name Lillian Beale, born in Carlisle, Pennsylvania, 1935. Mm-hmm. Married Paul Richard House.
Right,
she was not a twin. Had an older sister who went to England 20 years ago and an older brother who died in 1987.
Right here. This is it.
This is where we were.
I know. And I was sitting right there after you left.
And I was having a glass of, you know, wine, and I looked out the window, and I saw that right here. Yes, I saw her on a bus. It was passing. It was like.
Wait, are you? You're absolutely sure you saw her? You saw her face?
I'm positive. I saw her. Ooh, excuse me. I'm telling you,
Ted. What was the number on the bus?
I don't know what the number on the bus was, but I know that it was heading west to east, so it was obviously a crosstown
bus. Look, it's a crosstown bus.
Right.
Okay, so look, the end of the line is a few blocks down there.
So then her destination was probably within the next five or six blocks.
Yeah, right. So let's look around. Maybe we'll see some, like a clue or something. Maybe we'll see her. You sure?
I think we've reached the end of the line.
Geez, he's turning. That's it.
Yeah,
that's
I know. Well, what do you think?
What?
Think we should retrace our steps?
You wear a tie with a dress.
I don't think it looks good. And I don't even know if it looks. I mean, I feel like I'd be too masculine if I wore it with a pair of pants.
No, just don't wear it with pants. Oh. With pants, it's.
Ted, look.
Ted, what?
That hotel.
What about it?
Well, that's Waldron. I was in his apartment. I pressed the number, last number dialed, and.
You're kidding.
And they answered the phone.
Let's get to a phone. Let's call him up. You got a quarter? Hello, Mrs. House, please. Mrs. House, can you ring her room for me, please? Yeah. Really? What? Maybe she checked out. No, nobody at all. What about Helen Moss? Moss. You sure? Nobody at all. All right. Okay, I'm sorry. All right, thank you.
Great. Oh God, it looks like it's gonna rain again. Well,
if I get two kings, I take one. Otherwise, I fold.
I never go out. I can't.
That's how you wind up on welfare.
But I need the action for some reason. I can't go. I've got anything. Okay, just.
Cut.
No, go ahead. I trust you. Grab on me.
You seem in a strange mood.
No. I'm just probably just a little drunk.
Perrier?
Oh, what are you talking about? I had rum cake.
Want any cards?
Let me see what I can possibly take out here. I'm gonna have, I'll have four cards.
Four?
Yeah.
Bruising for a bruising.
Inside and outside street.
You're in trouble now.
I can't escape the feeling that my wife is becoming attracted to somebody else. And it's really bothering me.
Really?
Yeah, so I'm not playing my best. This guy's, more adventurous than I am, and for some reason they just seem to hit it off. I'm gonna be very lonely if this happens.
You must love her a lot.
Yeah, I do.
Well, if you want to hold on to her, you have to make some effort. I mean, who's the guy?
Ted, the guy that I fixed you up with.
Ted?
Yeah.
Well, we can always switch. Ted gets Carol, I can be your date.
Maybe I should actually make a greater effort with Carol.
So you bored?
Well, it's more fun than the Wagner opera.
Yeah, well, to me, it's just one of the most exciting adventures I've ever been on.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Would you rather be here with Ted?
Well, he has a more enthused attitude, Larry.
More enthused?
Yeah, enthused.
Well, he's a fun guy. He's a light guy. I'm a heavy guy. Ted would be fun on a scavenger hunt.
Larry, you used to be a
lot
of fun.
He's the guy you want if you really have a heavy scavenger hunt. He's the man.
I know, but, you used to...
Do you know that this neighborhood was
where I first took you out on a date when we first started going out.
Just for some reason, you've gotten so stodgy in your old age.
Hey, do you,
you
remember
know?
There was a movie house right on this corner?
Yeah, I remember.
Not to change the subject. No, I took you to see last year at Marion
Bed
on the first date.
Yeah, I know. I had to explain it to you for the next 6 months.
Who knew they were flashbacks? You know, that picture.
Look, Larry, look, we've got plenty of time to be conservative. You know what I'm saying? Don't you see? It's to me, it's like this tantalizing plum is just like dropped into our laps. I mean, life is just such a dull routine, and here we are, right? I mean, we're on the threshold of a genuine mystery. I mean, to me, the whole thing is like... Just don't make fun of me, okay? Because I'm open to new experiences.
Let me ask you a personal question here. Yeah? Did you ever sleep with Ted? Don't get nervous. Yeah, yeah, you guys, we went on an eating tour of France together, and you two guys spent an evening, you know, together in a place.
Yeah, but what about you? Remember? You spent the evening with Julie, am I right? You spent
that
the night
meant
shared.
Absolutely nothing. She hated me. Julie despised me. You know that. She thought I was a lowlife and a wimp and a vermin and a roach. Just jump in anytime you want to defend me.
Hey, I mean, I'm waiting for you to say something I don't agree with, okay?
Oh, you're nailing me. Jesus.
Oh, Larry, 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 look, it's her. I see, it's her.
Oh, my God, it is.
You see what I mean? See, so I was right all along, wasn't
sure?
I? I'm
are
positive.
Sure?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Right? Right? I mean, it was...
Jesus, I'm sure.
I know. Well, come
that
on.
That is her.
Yeah,
I
know.
I told you so.
What do you mean you told? What are you talking about? You're nuts, honey.
Jesus, I'm
yeah, no, look, you're white. You're completely
white. I know.
All
the blood rushed to my brother.
Larry,
I don't know what to do.
Let's go. Let's get out there. Let's find out
no,
what's going on.
I don't want
no,
to.
Come on. You're not afraid of her, are
no,
you?
I'm not afraid of Mrs.
House?
Old woman, and I'm a virile male.
I know.
And yet somehow I am scared. I don't know
come
why.
On.
Maybe
let's
because
go.
She's dead.
Then I tell you, I'm going to break this thing wide open.
Well,
like,
how?
You know,
what do you want to do?
God, if only Ted were here with us now.
Don't give me
saying?
Ted. Let's get out of here.
No, wait, I got an idea.
What?
I know what we should do. We should get a gift, right?
What?
We'll surprise her. We'll sneak into the hotel. Come on.
How?
Yeah, no, come on.
Excuse me. Hi. We were just wondering, did you see a woman come in? She was a little woman, about 5'3". She
older
had on a gray
woman.
Sweater.
With a canvas bag and an umbrella.
Mrs. Kane
uh-huh.
Not here.
Mrs.
Kane? Oh, yes. Uh-huh. That's
Mrs.
her.
Kane,
yes.
We had a present for her. We're friends. We want to surprise her.
Yes, that's right. What
birthday,
room
so
was she?
611.
611.
Oh,
really,
okay.
Thanks
okay.
a lot.
Sure.
Yeah, we may need some information while we're here, so Jen, I'll take very good care of your blood ball with us. What are you making a face for? He was the father of our country.
Will you come on?
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Okay. Six and seven.
Very nice. I love a hotel that's got lots of blue powder sprinkled along the baseboard.
11. Here, Larry.
All right.
Mrs. House?
Hello?
Hello?
This may not be the right place.
No. Just hold on, Larry. Hold on.
Nothing here.
Larry!
What's the
matter? Oh my God, wait a minute. Oh my God! Look, Mrs. House!
Oh,
Mrs.
What's
House?
The matter?
Hello?
Larry? What?
I think she's dead.
Try giving her the present.
Mrs. House?
Oh, come on, let's get out of here. Come on.
Oh my God.
I'm gonna run the Boston Marathon. This
okay.
woman is forever dying.
Oh God.
Come on, move. Adrenaline is leaking out of my ears. Get down the stairs. Come on, quickly.
And then you see what happened
was
I suspected
she
Mr. House, right?
So
he runs a movie house.
And then I'm looking around the place, and then suddenly her hand
bus,
is on the floor. You
and,
can see it
and
on the
she
side of the bed. She was laying
no
there. She was still
all,
like blue
then we
in the face.
Anyway.
The
so
girl
then we
was
just
nervous.
Like
I tried to keep calm as best I could.
There's what?
What do you mean there's
nobody
up there?
There's nobody there.
How can there not be anybody
exactly
up there?
Yes.
We just saw her there. She was laying on the floor.
Barry,
she was totally dead.
She's there.
Wait.
She was right here. She was lying.
She was definitely
like,
laying
right
here.
This way. Because, I mean, yes. she was
it looks
there.
Like she was strangled or something. Not that I'm an expert on violent death, because I wouldn't
people.
Know any. Right. I work at Hoppers. I'm in publishing.
That's right. And I'm looking to start a little restaurant, basically French, although international cuisine would be
cook.
Fine.
Fantastic.
Not that
I'm against
really
the restaurant
location.
Myself. Calm
but
down. She's a wonderful cook.
Calm down.
Okay.
Look, obviously what happened is, in the time it took you guys to respond, somebody came here and removed the body. Not that you didn't respond quickly. You were here fast. It took 3 minutes. Not counting the half hour that the operator at 911 took to understand what I was saying.
Nobody's so doubting you, okay? We're going over the whole building, all right?
All right. Did you check?
Mr. House.
You check
He's been in this place of business all day.
Oh.
Any witnesses?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Backed up and corroborated.
Yeah, but you didn't use our names or anything like that, did
no,
you?
No, we didn't.
No,
I don't
okay.
know. If you think you saw his wife, shouldn't you tell him?
No, I mean, he's in on some sort of scheme here.
We think you should come down and file a report. Oh. This way, if anything turns up, we got it on record. Take a card, give us a call, have a good day.
Thank you. Thanks
Bye-bye.
Very much. Thanks very much.
I gotta
have
a drink. I gotta
calm
myself. I need.
What is Ted? I just don't understand what Ted is when you know all this stuff is happening.
Ted's, you know, he's got his date with Marcia Fox tonight. He's probably out buying some Spanish fly.
I think Helen Moss might be in on this.
Helen, I don't want to know about this. I think we should change our lives.
Think
about
it.
Move out of that stupid apartment. You know, start over. Maybe in Mexico.
Yeah,
you know, sell blankets. We'll work off the hood of a car or something.
I'm just beginning to come down.
I don't know what's happening. It's like one of those television shows where you open the door and you see a dead body. You know, I always hated those shows.
Yeah, you know, I've never seen a dead person before in my whole life.
The only one I ever saw was my Uncle Morris, who was 94 years old. He collapsed from too many lumps in his cereal.
Larry, is this the most exciting thing that's ever happened to us in our whole marriage?
This is too exciting. I don't need this. You know, I like something, I like a fishing trip or Father's Day, you know, or the time we saw Bing Crosby walking on Fifth Avenue. You know, I don't need a murder to enliven my life at all.
You know, whoever did it was probably still in the room while we were there, probably hiding in the closet.
Make sure and tell me that just before I go to sleep tonight. That'll be good for me.
But you know, that means he probably saw us.
Great. I'll never get my eyes closed. You know, what do you want me to do? I'm petrified. Not only that, but I'm a little drunk.
I wonder who was cremated. Who was it?
Well, it was, you know, obviously it wasn't Mr. House because he has an alibi.
Oh, yeah, but I don't buy that.
She doesn't buy it. She doesn't buy the alibi. Let's get out of here. I'm gonna go home. Jesus, it's starting to rain again. Can you believe that?
God, if only Ted were with us, he would have had a million theories about
this. I know.
This.
Ted's got a mind like a steel sieve.
All right.
You know what I think?
Funny.
I think it's possible. That
what?
Hotel room was on the end of the hall. It's right up there. That's the room.
I know.
Well, what if they got the body out over that little roof? You know, that would be a possibility. While
what are the lights?
Oh,
Larry,
geez.
The lights.
Yeah,
my
that's
God.
Eerie, isn't
this
it?
This give me the chills, honey.
Yeah, well, let's call the police.
Oh, no, come on, let's go over there now. Let's check it out. Come on,
check
we don't
it
have time.
Out? What are you, nuts? No, I'm not going to check that out.
No, but look at it, Larry, look at that. There's lights going on there.
Yeah, no, I know, that's crazy. Why don't we go home and nap and we'll call the police and they can check it out.
Oh,
while
no,
we're
the
home
police
and...
are red tape. Come on, this is my case, honey.
What do you mean it's your
yes,
case?
It's
hey,
my
come
case.
No, I don't want to do this.
No, come on. Oh, God, if only Ted were with
hey,
us.
Hey, don't give me Ted. Ted would be shaking in his boots. I'm at least just trembling like a leaf.
Excuse me, we're with the police department. We'd like to check out room 611, please.
You are here before.
And that's right, yes. Uh-huh. Yeah.
You are police?
Show him your card.
Your what?
Your card. Your police identification.
Yeah,
your card, you know? Your card. He's got his card. Yeah,
okay.
Thank you very much, 611. Okay. Great.
Is there any trouble?
No. I'm a detective. They lowered the height requirement, so I'll take this card back there. Spencer.
Okay.
Be careful.
I'm gonna be careful. Don't upset anything, okay,
Larry?
I'm
not upsetting anything. I just, you know, I'm just going to leave a set of fingerprints around so when there's a trial, we can get trapped.
All right, now look, the murderer must have, like, hid in this closet, right?
I don't like this.
Right,
let's go. You know, I got to be up early tomorrow. I got to be in Temple.
Okay, you must have dragged the body out really fast.
Shh. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm diminutive.
Oh, you don't have to turn the bed out. It's not necessary. And no croissants tomorrow for breakfast. Yeah. Here, take this for yourself. I like the towels. Keep the little mints coming on the pillow.
Larry, really?
Let's go. Okay, that's why the light was on. This is crazy. We're going to get in trouble.
Larry. Can you just look around here just a little bit?
Oh, look, I did damage. Now I'll be sorry.
Larry!
What's what?
Larry, look. Look. I think that's her wedding band, Larry.
How do you know?
How do I know? I saw it on her.
You did?
Yeah.
Jesus.
I think so.
So much for the police combing every inch of this place. Where'd you find it?
I found it behind the floor, right there.
Oh, brother, let's get out of here. Come on. Amazing. Take the ring with you. Maybe there's a pawn shop open.
Okay. Didn't I tell you the police weren't very thorough? I mean, they probably thought we were cranks, right? I mean, we got no body, and I mean, they must get 50 crisis calls a minute. Why would they bother with us?
I don't know. I just know this is very deep stuff. We should not be here. I'm scared. Yeah. This is creepy. You know what I mean? This could be, who knows who's involved in this? This could go very deep, Carol. This could be like, you know, like with the Warren Commission or something. Oh, I don't like it.
Commission. Oh, my
God. Jesus, what is that?
Okay, all right, now look, all right. The elevator's probably
stuck. Why are we stopping?
Relax now, Larry.
Don't tell me to relax. I'm a world-renowned claustrophobic.
It's okay, everything's going to be fine. Something. I am hitting it.
I don't like this.
I know.
It's easy for you to say, but I can't breathe. I'm phobic.
The idea is there's plenty of air in this elevator. Larry, relax. You just don't panic, okay? Don't panic, all right?
I'm not panicking.
Just don't worry.
I'm just going to say the rosary now.
Somebody will help us. Somebody's going to help us. Somebody will find us here. Hello?
I don't like this.
Hello?
Press something. Stop it.
Hello?
I can't take this.
Oh, God. Well,
I'm running over a field.
Yeah,
I see open meadows. I see a stallion. I'm a stallion.
Shut up, Larry. Larry, just shut up and calm down.
I see grass. You're gonna be dirt.
Larry, shut up. Hello?
You said act like a policeman.
I know.
Said no.
Yeah.
You said pretend to be a policeman.
Okay, wait a minute.
You said show me
God.
I said what God?
Larry, boost me up. We'll get out there. We're going to do it.
You can't get through those things.
Yes, we can. I can do it.
They never open. They're painted shut.
Don't worry.
They never
open. All right, get your hand together. Come on. Put your hand together.
I'm breathing.
No, it's okay. Larry.
I can't breathe.
Larry, all I have to do is loosen that, okay?
The hairs.
All right, put your hand together. Put your hand together. Now, give me a boost, okay? All right, you ready? Wait a second. Wait.
Jesus, you got to cut down on those rich desserts.
Oh, wait a minute now. Just wait.
Let's go. My life is passing in front of my eyes. The worst part of it is I'm driving a used car.
Okay. Now you think they'd loosen this stupid thing.
No. I'm scared.
Oh my God.
It's her.
So that's where he hit her.
Oh, Jesus. Claustrophobia and a dead body. This is the neurotic's jackpot. We're going down.
Oh, God.
We're going down.
Oh, God. Press up.
Press up? I can't see my hand. How can I press up? Jesus.
We must be heading for the basement, Larry.
The basement. I want to get off in the mezzanine. I'm returning shoes.
Okay.
It's dark here. Where are you? I'm getting back on the elevator.
No,
I don't care. I can't see anything.
There's nothing up here. What are you doing? Hey, what are you doing with matches?
Yeah, these are my matches. I got them.
Wait a minute. When were you at the Café des Artistes?
I was with an authoress.
At the Café des Artistes?
Yes, a French authoress. I like a basement with knotty pine and a pool table. And, you know, where
look. What's this?
Wait a minute. Not so fast. I don't like it here. It's dank and there's strange noises. Yeah. Jesus.
Oh. Calm down.
Calm down. Don't tell me to calm down.
Let me see. We're locked in here. What are we going to do?
Relax. I'll break it down. Stand
careful
back.
Now.
Just give me a second.
Don't hurt yourself.
I'm not going to hurt myself. Must be one of those new doors.
Okay, no. Over here. Let's try out here.
Hearing noises.
What's down there?
Where?
What?
Where you can don't hey, where are you going? Don't
leave.
Okay.
What? Oh, yeah. I think this is it.
Well, come on.
I'm trying.
Come on, get it open. Go into a trot. Let's go home.
Where? Oh. Wait. Did you see that? Looks like somebody's putting a body into a car. I swear, look, it's got a white sheet on it.
Yes.
Like, yeah. Come on.
That is.
Let's follow him. I don't want to follow a car with a body in it. Hurry up!
It's probably a rented car or a rented body. I'm not a good driver. I can't chase somebody in a car. I'm going to have an accident. I'll wind up hitting a school bus or something.
It's nighttime. There's no school buses at nighttime.
Don't tell me that. What about night school?
No, I do have a sixth.
What is this?
I don't know.
But
there it is. There's his car right there.
Do you know it's his car?
That's his car.
Yes.
Look at
him.
Tell them what? I mean, this guy, you know, he's got proof his wife died of a heart attack 2 weeks ago. We've got no body. We've got nothing, Larry.
Oh.
What? What? What's wrong? What?
Hello there.
Hey.
How are you?
How are you?
Can I introduce Gladys Dalton, my
Mrs.
gal
how are
Friday?
You? Hello. Nice to
this
see you.
This is Larry and Carol, my neighbors.
Yes, nice to see you.
We're just watching Madame Bovary.
Oh, such a sad story.
Yeah, it is.
She gets cremated. She gets killed at the end.
Yeah. Listen, you've got to stop up for a drink before I go on my trip.
Love to.
See you later.
Oh,
incidentally, if you hear of anybody who needs an apartment, I think I may be moving.
Oh.
See you later. Come on, Gladys.
What a shame.
Good night.
Night.
Jesus. What a day, huh? I can't figure it out.
Mm-mm.
It's got to be that
what?
Either she's a twin or he's a twin. Or are there multiple personalities? Mm. Or you're a twin or I'm a twin. Because I don't know going on. You know?
Let me
be logical about
this. Okay, she's not a twin. We know she's not a twin.
Hey.
What are you talking about, Larry?
Stay calm. I want to try
calm,
and puzzle
this out. Okay, but... Okay, she's a twin. She's not a twin. Saying we're twins. What are you, nuts? Okay, I'm calm. Okay.
Yeah, I want to be logical.
All right.
The first thing is this. We came home that night. There'd been a heart attack. Well, what if they induced it? You know, some kind of poison. We never saw the body. You know, it had to be some other woman. You know, some woman who probably had some kind of ballpark resemblance to Mrs. House. The super says he saw her, but he's a drunk, you know. Mrs. House could have been hiding.
Oh.
Right, you remember that you heard a noise that night. That had to be Mrs. House leaving to check into the hotel.
Yeah, well.
I can't sleep. I just...
No, wait a minute. It doesn't make any sense at all, Larry. Because suddenly, you know, he murders her. I mean, what's it all about?
Let me call Vincent's restaurant in New Jersey, and why don't we go meet Ted and Marcia and get something to eat
and
talk with them.
Wait a minute. At 1 in the morning?
Yeah, so what? Don't worry.
Ted was taking her to a show and to dinner.
All the way out to
New Jersey.
Kid, this is the Apple. This is a town that never sleeps. That's why we don't live in Duluth. That plus, I don't know where Duluth is. Lucky me.
You really saw his face. You saw when he looked at me. I'm here to tell you it was Mr. Harris. There was not a question.
I mean, you could see him because, you know, there was just no way that you could avoid it. He was right.
To me, it's obvious.
How obvious? What do you mean?
Obvious he's committed the perfect murder.
Okay,
look. You have to start off with another woman who bears some ballpark resemblance to Mrs. House.
Yeah. That's what I said. I use the term ballpark resemblance myself. It was my idea.
They're with this woman.
Yeah.
Maybe having dinner. They don't induce a heart attack because that's fiction bullshit. She has a heart attack. She drops dead spontaneously. They had no thought of killing her. Maybe they wish she was dead.
Why?
I don't know. Maybe they stood to gain if she died. They see a golden opportunity. Mrs. House dresses her up in her clothes. She hides.
This is my theory. Exactly my theory.
That's right. She checks into a hotel.
Yeah, well, we got that far with the exception of the actual spontaneous heart attack.
Okay, you know the husband's planning to go to Paris with this pretty young woman?
Yeah.
He's cheating on his wife. So instead of finishing the scheme they planned, he double-crosses her and kills her, taking her share of the profits.
Well, you think Helen Moss is in on this, too?
Yeah, good chance she's aware.
Okay, but what about Mrs. Dalton? He claims he took her to the movies.
She's his alibi. She covered for him when he strangled his wife. She said he was at work all day.
That's right, because he introduced her as a colleague.
A colleague who maybe loves him.
Oh,
wait, he's cheating on her, too.
Cheating on two women?
Yeah, it's perfect.
This guy doesn't look the part. Oh,
the point is, he's gotten away with a perfect murder. There are no bodies around to prove anything, and all the paperwork's strictly above board. He's home free.
Oh, where did you find this woman? She's a genius.
She was brilliant. But the guy, he knows that we know, so he's not out of the
world. He doesn't care. Why should he? Everything's been neatly disposed of. He's home free. Only he and maybe his mistress know the truth.
Well,
there's no body.
Hold on one second. We don't know this is all true. This is just a theory.
Yeah, but it's a great theory. Yeah, you paying attention? This is a great theory.
Everything fits together in this.
I think it's great.
When I come back from the ladies' room, I'll tell you how to trap him.
Oh, shoot.
Where did you find her?
She's really something.
She's got one idea after another. It's like one thing leads to another.
I'm surprised you two didn't drill yourselves to death.
We just had a nice first date.
Yeah. I knew that they would hit it off.
Yeah, him.
I knew this.
Yeah, huh? What about you? You were going to jump into her lap. I saw you, Larry.
What are you talking about? What's wrong with you? I'm her editor. I'm the father figure to her.
Yeah, the only thing you didn't do was rub your hands together. That was it.
Well, you gotta be joking. Are you telling me that you're jealous of Marcia?
Well, it's not that I'm jealous.
Kids, people.
Thank you.
People, what are we doing here?
Yeah, look who's talking. My God, I mean, you kept staring into her eyes like she was the dragon lady.
What's wrong with you? You're jealous because he's interested in her?
I'm interested in her theory. I'd just
like to know if you take all your... authors to lunch.
Okay, I've got it. Here's the story. Since he's gotten away with it, all we can do is bluff. As long as we have no body, we have no case.
What do you mean? What do we pretend that he slipped up and the molten steel didn't do the job? What do you mean?
Yeah, it's possible. He saw you there. He knows you're on to him. After he ran away, why couldn't you retrieve the body?
You're kidding. We couldn't have gotten out. I would have wound up with a few toes and a shoulder, maybe, at most.
Okay, you have the body. What does he know? He was probably too scared to be very lucid. He's an amateur. He dumped the body and ran off, and then somehow, who knows the details, you two dug her out. Now you can send him to the chair.
Okay.
Just... I like this woman. She's lurid.
Let me tell you why he's not going to believe us, okay?
Yeah, first of all, because I can't bluff or lie without giggling.
Yeah. No, because... If we really had the body, why tell him? Why not go straight to the police?
If you tell the cops, you can't shake him down.
Oh, she's wicked. Look how this works out. You go to the law. What do you gain? I mean, so maybe they, you know, they put him in jail. What have you got? You haven't got anything.
Right.
But if he wants the evidence and he's got to pay for it, okay, now he's nervous.
Yeah,
right?
No, wait, there's just so many fallacies in this, I can't even count them.
What? Name one.
Name one. Okay, the guy looks us straight in the eyes and says, what body? What the hell are you talking about? Prove it.
Well, that's when we keep bluffing.
What? How? What do we do?
We produce the body.
Yeah, but we're going to get it, Madame Tussauds?
Yeah. Say we found someone to corroborate this story. Someone he trusted.
Like who?
Like his lover. Say she called and said, Paul, I've just seen Lillian's body. Uh-uh. They want
$100,000. Why would she do that?
Remember that book you recommended to me? Murder in Manhattan?
Oh, yes, Max Schindler's book. That's right, The Phone Call.
I don't remember that book. You never mentioned that book to me.
No, because you don't like light reading.
Since
so
when
I never...
don't I like light reading,
I
Larry?
I don't know this book. What
so
is this book?
It's fantastic. It would be so perfect because she's an actress, a would-be actress anyhow, and he could use his theater. He's a playwright. This is so perfect. Your theater is empty all the time anyhow.
Oh,
so,
God.
Thank you. It's great. What are we talking about here? What do you mean? What is this?
What you do is... We get her in for a fake audition, and you write some lines that don't mean anything. And she does them, and she doesn't know what she's doing, and we tape record it. Listen to this.
I'm listening.
And then we edit it up. We edit the tape recording up, and we make one end of a phone call, and we play it into the phone to Mr. House.
This is in the book?
Come on.
Yes.
No, that could never, ever work. In a million years, you don't know what he's going to say.
In the book, they use several tape recorders.
In the
book. We coordinate
it's coordinated.
In the book. I mean, you're basing your plan on some dumb paperback?
This is great.
You know, really. Oh.
He's gotten away with murder. Our only chance is to nab him as he tries to kill again, cover his tracks.
It's great. What happens is it provokes him to kill again. They catch him the second time.
Exactly. He's gotten away with the first murder.
You know what I'm thinking, though?
What?
Actually, in the book, what happens is, now that I think of it, he kills the two people that are working this scheme on him.
Yeah, that's right. But you're not worried about that.
It's perfect.
I don't know. Either that or I've just developed Parkinson's.
No, we can handle him.
It's
listen,
perfect.
This is incredible.
He knows you're
on to
him. You shake
idea.
Him down. No, no. He comes after
it's
you.
Great.
We nab him.
It's great. You're wonderful. I'm amazed.
Yeah.
It's either that or he walks.
Yeah. Wait. So what you're saying is...
Great.
Wait, no, okay. What you're saying... Oh, boy. You're saying you want to provoke Mr. House into trying to murder Larry and me.
Yeah. It's perfect. You're not scared, are you?
No. I'm not scared. I'm just turning it over in my mind. I just want to check with my clergyman before we commit.
Hi, B24, messages? Oh, really? Audition for what? Did he say? Okay. Wait, hold on. Let me get a pencil. Okay.
Yeah, well, Dad, you know, I've heard just about enough of this.
Good. That's great. Thank you, Suzanne. Thank
we'll
you.
Let you know. That's Suzanne
yeah.
Raphael, right?
Good. Thank you.
Bye.
This is Helen Moss.
Hi there. Hi.
Have you, I know you just got the material, just in the last little while, but have you had a chance to study it, to go over it a little bit?
Yes, I have, but I have just a few questions.
Sure, yeah.
Is she divorced in this?
Yes.
Recently?
Yes. Yeah. But she's very highly emotional.
Yeah.
You know, really a lot of feeling. Very strong. Okay.
Should I just begin?
Yeah, just whenever you feel it, whenever you feel into it. Okay.
Mm. Hello, Joe.
Let me stop you right there. I'm sorry. If you'll start out more frightened, then that'll take you where you're going to go.
Right. Hello, Joe. I can't talk much now, and if I sound strange, don't get alarmed. Give me your hand. Hold on. Try not to fall. Hold on.
I'm trying.
Quickly, hurry. They're asking $200,000 for it. Yeah, they say it's Monet, but I say it's a fake. Ever since Joe came home from Vietnam, he's cast a pall on everything. A dark cloud, a pall.
Hello, Joe. I can't talk much right now. And if I sound strange, don't get alarmed.
Hello, Joe. I can't talk much right now. Hello, Joe. Ever since Joe came back from Vietnam, he's cast a pall on everything. A dark cloud. A pall. A pall. 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 Hello, Joe.
Hello, Joe.
Hello, Paul. I can't talk much right now, and if I sound strange, don't get alarmed.
Perfect. Great.
Well, yeah, it's great. Me, honey, don't worry. Thank you. Fantastic.
There she is.
Where?
You have to keep her busy for all afternoon.
Okay, I'll just keep improvising, you know?
Okay, well, it shouldn't be too hard. She's a hungry actress or a playwright.
You know what? I'll talk about the player. I'll get her talking about her part, you know, her life. I'll get her talking about her life and her whole background. Stop the car. I'm going to get out
of here. We'll hook up later,
all right,
okay?
Good luck with your side of it, okay?
Listen, does anybody want some guacamole?
Stop the guacamole. We have to get started with this. Do you know what?
She should be back for lunch, right?
Yeah. All right, let's go.
So everybody's got the right tape recorder?
Yes.
All right, one second.
Speaker.
I'm not nervous.
So we have to come to a complete. Nobody is here. You see if we can find. I'll get the phone. You go to call.
Yes. All right.
Hello.
Hello, Paul. I can't talk much right now, and if I sound strange, don't get alarmed.
What's the problem?
They have your wife's body. They showed it to me.
Say that again.
They have your wife's body. They showed it to me.
Exactly who has it? How many are there?
Your neighbors. That's right. They want $200,000 for it.
Where are you calling from? There's an echo. Are you on a speakerphone?
Hold on.
We don't have an answer for that. What do we do?
Go to a different thought.
Mm-hmm. What thought?
Wait.
Shh. You either got to pay them off or get rid of them.
Look, we can't talk about this on the phone. Can you meet me?
Yes. They're keeping it refrigerated.
What? What'd you say?
About 2 hours ago.
What? 2 hours what?
Hold on.
Jesus, we're all screwed up. I got this all screwed up.
Okay, let's get off as quick as possible.
All right, well,
we've done it.
Do something.
Shh. Okay.
Hello, Paul. I can't talk much right now, and if I sound strange, don't get alarmed.
Look, Helen, you're not making any sense. I know you're upset, but you have to pull yourself together. Now, can we meet? The usual spot.
Hold on.
Helen? Helen, are you still there? Helen?
Okay, hurry up. Okay.
Somebody press something. Come on, you can't press something. Come on.
You have no choice. They've got the goods. You just pay them off or get rid of them. I have to hang up.
What's the matter, Paul? You look all shaken up.
No, I'm all right. It's nothing.
I worry about you these days, Paul.
I'm fine.
You're different.
I said I was fine. You stop interfering.
You never used to pull away from me.
I told you to leave me alone. I don't want to have this conversation all the time.
Great. All right, now my job is to wait exactly 1 hour and call Mr. House from the phone booth. Where are you running so fast?
I have to go home and change. I've got an appointment with a friend of Ted's about a location for what?
What are you so steamed up about?
Well, I just don't understand how you could give a book to Marcia and not to me.
What are you just talking about?
We just had a big success in there. Marsha likes to read what I like to read.
Oh, right, God, yeah. Well, it's true. I guess it's true. I mean, we got nothing in common, that's for sure. Now that Nick's grown up, I mean, you know, we're just left facing each other.
You got stuff in common with Ted, right? You can cook together with Ted, or you can take your clothes off and baste the chicken with him.
Oh, well, what about you and Marsha, huh? What does she teach you besides poker? That's what I'd like to
wrestling.
Know.
Okay. Is that what you want to hear? Look, nothing. I'm her editor.
I think the time has come for us to reevaluate our lives.
I reevaluated our lives. I got a 10, you got a 6.
Well, listen, I think maybe I will go back to seeing my shrink. I think you don't have to see your shrink.
There's nothing wrong with you that can't be cured with a little Prozac and a polo mallet.
I just would like to be alone for a while, okay, Larry? Okay?
So I have this, like, really crazy father and everything.
Yeah.
And, yeah, he's wanted, like, in 3 states. He has a terrible driving record. So we had to move from Virginia then to New Jersey.
So your father is wanted in 3 states
for driving?
Driving,
yeah.
Really?
So I moved to Hackensack, and then, well, anyway, I was in all these different contests, and I was even Miss Teenage Passaic.
Oh, how wonderful. Yeah. Oh, that's good. Was that before or after the 4th abortion?
Well, after the 4th, but before the drama prize.
The drama prize?
Mm-hmm.
Remember.
Remember? Out, damn spot, the topless Macbeth.
Oh, yeah, oh, for the fraternity party.
Yeah, yeah.
Topless Macbeth.
Great.
How can I forget that?
Hello, Mr. House. This is Larry Lipton. I got a package I think you're gonna want. Because it's gonna cost you $200,000 in small unmarked bills. Or large marked ones, if you wanna go that route.
And I have a package you might want, Mr. Lipton. If you ever want to see your wife alive again, you'll do as I say.
Really? Well, I think you're bluffing. Yeah, don't ever try and bluff a bluffer. If you got Carol, put her on the phone.
Oh, Larry, help me. I'm here, Larry.
Oh, my God. Don't hurt her.
I'll tell you exactly where to meet me, and you bring that package I want. Now, once I have it and I'm safely gone, you'll get your wife back. Otherwise, I'll kill her.
Yes. Yes, no, I understand. I'll be there, I'll bring your wife's body in the trunk of my car. Yes, I promise, I'll be there. I don't have his wife's body. Bluff. Carol.
First, show me Lillian's body.
I got it.
There's no way she could have survived that vat of molten steel.
No, I got...
Not bluffing, where is she?
Why are you so nervous? I don't have her.
Where is she?
I got her in the trunk of my car.
Open it. Come on, now.
I got her.
She's not there. I'll pull a bullet through your head. Now, open it. Come on. Step back.
No, I got her. See, if I don't have her, how come I got a ring? I got her in there. This is her ring. It's a... No.
What is this?
I could never bluff.
What?
I've lost a fortune in cards over the years. I'm not a bluffer.
Get up.
She meant to kill Frisbee, too, after he served his purpose. Poor howling idiot. He never even did that. He went and shot Broome, and that was not part of the plan. Broome might have got to the police before he died. And if the cops traced it to Frisbee, and the cops made Frisbee talk, he'd spill everything, and she'd be finished. So she had to shut up, Grisby, but quick. And I was the fall guy.
Shot.
And what about me?
Oh, we could have got off together.
One who follows his nature.
Help! Help!
They can't see us behind the screen. And they can't hear us with the sound on. Not even a gunshot.
I knew I'd find you.
Hello, Paul.
If I hadn't.
Didn't you expect me?
Mrs. Dalton.
You made a lot of promises to me over the years. And then you decided to dump me for that young model.
I never led you on.
It's late for excuses.
None of you can prove anything.
So you'd be foolish to fire that gun. These mirrors
are
difficult to tell.
Carol,
you are aiming at me, aren't you?
I'm aiming at you, lover.
Of course, killing you is killing myself.
Of course, killing you is killing myself.
Same thing.
But you know, I'm pretty tired of both of us.
Life. Are you all right?
Yes, I'm all right.
You don't know what's going on out there. I'll never say that life doesn't imitate art again.
We gotta call the police.
Yes, and a glazier.
Oh, God.
Quick, dial.
Oh, Larry. Oh, God, Larry. Oh, God. Oh, God. Ow.
I'm sorry.
God. Jeez.
Oh, wife mine.
Hello?
Wife mine.
Oh, God, no.
God. So complicated. I can't keep track of it all.
Oh, listen. I'll give it to you one more time. Mrs. House had a sister who moved to England many years ago.
She changed her name when she married. Her husband died. She moved back to New York recently, a very, very rich widow, but a recluse. Mr. and Mrs. House knew they weren't in her will. They have her over to dinner. She accidentally keels over. I guessed right there. She has a reasonable resemblance to her sister, so they fake it. Pretend Lillian House died. They cremate the sister. Lillian checks into a flea bag joint, and for several weeks she pretends to be her sister, closing her accounts, liquidating her assets, accumulating big money.
What she didn't realize is her husband was two-time heir with Helen Moss, his pretty model. So he decides not to cut her in and go off to, I don't know, with his mistress and keep all the dough. So he kills Lillian, he cremates her, pours molten steel all over her or something, and that's when we came along and tripped him up.
He had some great alibis.
Yeah, that woman who worked for him, Mrs. Dalton, she covered for him. She loved him. Not that she dreamed he was a murderer.
I want to celebrate or something. What do you want to do? You want to go see what Larry and Carol are up to?
I think they want to be alone.
Oh, yeah. Okay, all right. Would you have any plans?
You're taking me to dinner, right?
Yeah, right. Absolutely. Only we can't sleep together.
Why not?
Not tonight. Well, I already slept with Helen Moss once today, and I'm not young and active like I used to.
You'll do anything to catch a murderer, won't you? Mm-hmm.
What an experience.
Oh,
I'm still vibrating.
I know. Oh,
incredible.
You know, Larry. You were surprisingly brave.
Really surprisingly? You seem shocked.
Well,
I'm a pretty good guy.
Yeah, I know.
So where do you want to go for dinner tonight? Let's not eat at any restaurant where they serve cowards. You're laughing
at me.
You
know, Larry, I love you. I love you.
How could you ever have been jealous of Marsha? Isn't that ridiculous? Don't you know that I could only love you?
You were jealous of Ted.
Ted, yeah. What if the kitten take away his elevator shoes and his fake suntan and his cap teeth, and what do you have?
You.
Right. I like that.